Hello, hello, it's Wessel here, and thanks for joining me as I continue on my adventures in SnowRunner on hard mode. And today we're at day 57 here in Amur, so still got a bit to do yet though, but we are starting to make some progress through the tasks in Northern Aegis Installation, NAI, and now we're going to start focusing on the contracts. Today, I'm going to be loading up some cargo containers that we can take back for the humanitarian mission contract, and I'm also going to, importantly, switch the ZiKZ so that it has the seismic vibrator on it, so we can do the Richter scale contract. So let's have a bit of fun, get on with it, and see how we go as we go. First thing I'm going to do is bring these metal beams back. At least get them to the other side of the bridge. Eventually these have to go all the way out the eastern side to the church for the task up there. Switch to the ZiKZ. Is that the ZiKZ? That's not the ZiKZ. That's the ZiKZ. Just check its fuel. Yeah, it's fine. Okay. So we're all good. So we can head on over to the warehouse. So we're going to go with our little friend, the Voron. You may remember yesterday I was having a bit of fun trying to put the floor on around the flatbed. We won't bother doing that today. Again. Change to the ZiKZ. Thank you. Too many trucks nearby. It's not got a central winch spot at the back. It's got two winch spots. Going to head around the main road to get back to the warehouse. Put two cargo containers on the flatbed. Put two wooden planks into the traybed of the core. Slowly across this bridge, because last time I almost piffed the bore off, which is not a big deal because the ZiKZ could pick up. I certainly don't want to piff the ZiKZ. this guy next to the platform. Ooh, I hope we can get concrete blocks here. I better just check. Bring that one up. Bricks, wooden planks, concrete blocks, beauty. Fine. Oh, cargo containers. That's really one more, sorry. So I can get them too. Good. We'll put our crane out while we're sitting here. We'll grab our cargo containers. No, don't grab them though. Stop the engine. What are you doing? It's a Voron, isn't it? Okay, cargo management. We'll put it on the loading platform. Just leave it there for a second. So I've got two cargo containers and two wooden planks. Perfect. Thank you. ZiKZ. We are a bit short on it's pretty yucky on most trucks. I think the ZiKZ should be okay with it. So even the ZiKZ fast is yucky. Supplies, yep. To So he's got 165, so he's more than half full. That'll be enough to get him back to the fuel tanker, so that'll be okay. Right, now, let's try and do what we were doing before. This time I might actually try and go up over this snowy hill a bit more. So I think the snowy hill might be a little bit, well, it's going to be more tricky for trees. It's going to be easier to drive on. This is a ZiKZ, not a TAS 166. Turning circles not quite the same. Switch over and put on the Seismic Vibrator here. So we'll customize that. That's all we need to do. So we've still got our trunk supplies on the roof. to meet up with the step so we can refuel. So this should be okay. I'm a little bit nervous about this part. We might bail off it and jump down onto the ice shelf beside the river. But we'll see how we go. It's definitely not a super easy path for something as big as the ZiKZ. Little things are fine. But having all these side overhangs may cause a little bit of trouble as well. In a minute. Just yet. Scared that big tree. Yeah, it was a gated bottom. It's a little right along here. It's the next bit. It's the fun. So we have the option here of going down across the snow, not across the ice. And I'm actually thinking I'm going to take that option. I'm just nervous that it's a bit too wide this far. Head down here and then come back up onto the path once we pass the worst of it. So we'll refuel our truck supplies from ourselves. No, not the way around, sausage. I want to go from the ZiKZ to the truck supply. Right. And then we'll refuel from the steps fuel tank to the ZiKZ. Okay, and then we can come back to the Voron and bring it around together with the trailer. Now, slight fly in the ointment here is I can't attach the trailer because unfortunately the Voron's not a Holy Trinity truck. Best we can do is winch it. So winching, isn't it quite as good as having it attached to the tow bar? Here we go. It should be okay to bring it over. And we do have the crane, so if something bad happens, we can pick it up. The problem is, if we pick it up, we can't pack it again. So we really don't want it to fall off. A bit of extra help there from the trailer pushing our tail around. Just a little bit closer. That's as close as it can get. Coming this way, we're bringing it over the ice, and the Voron is happily able to come up over the ice. It's doing pretty well at the moment. Hopefully these rocks won't be mean to us. That big one right there is probably going to be mean. I think we got through. Now coming down this snowy part, we're just going to go pretty slow because I don't want the trailer suddenly take up a weird turn. So he's right off now. Because this is where we are most likely to tip the trailer on the floor. Coming on here. And keep the trailer away from that pole. Because I can't do the sneaky with us on. Yes. That's fine. What I'm doing is I'm trying to bring the red flatbed down here a bit further so it's down on the down the flat, literally. Okay, so what do we got? Okay, well that's not too bad at all. We've got one trailer standing up, and we've got one cargo still on it. So let's go back and get the other cargo. Cargo container. We can just pop them on top of our wooden planks for this little 5 meter run. chance of the hull. This is going to be beautiful. Actually, so we'll stop there. Restore aircraft. Stop the engine. Change the truck. No. And we're going to get the step. Because the step is able to connect up to this one. It's the only truck that is. So, very fortunate that it fell off so close to where we. Where we have the step. There you go, beautifully packed. And not only that, we can also refuel from the fuel tank to the port. Beautiful. And then we can run it down this hill here. And again, if it falls off, I've got the Voron right there to pick it up and put it back on again. Oh, let's try really hard. It doesn't work down here. Yeah, well, didn't expect that. The cargo is just so heavy. You decide. Up to there now. Yes, I think the weight of the trailer was just a bit too much for the step. With gravity on your side, we should be okay. Thank you. step will attach it. Everything's a bit in there. Still, we've got things that can sort of stand up again if we fall over. In the back of their own truck, we're a bit more stable than if we'd just been empty. So I'm pleased these are just cargo containers and not oversized cargo containers. That would have been very hard fiddling with the oversized ones. He's going to take it. At least it's nicely packed. Actually, you might as well hang around and refuel the ZiKZ when it gets here, I suppose. So I'll stop there. Voron's down here as well. Thanks. down here. The reason I'm doing this is because I need these later on. And I don't, as in to take into NAI, and I don't want to take the Voron in at the moment. We're going to be coming back with the ZiKZ after we finish doing the discard, giving it a high saddle so I can finish off the really big trailer contract. So we might as well do that. We still have the crane. In fact, we can stop you there. Get the ZiKZ. ZiKZ can come across. Bounce across the cross. Seismic vibrator thingy doover. You can't get access to the tow bar because it's got that steps all the way out anyway. Come on, bounce across the rocks. Get some grip. Time we're not going to be able to winch from the trailer, so we're just going to have to go slow. Might be that we've got to let it go, push on without it, all that sort of stuff. Once we get this trailer into NAI, we'll be able to use the Tayga to grab it. So we've just got to get it up to NAI without it tipping out. first part done now, I think, in terms of getting back to an hour. We've still got that part. Bit of cracky ice along here. Through we go to NAI. We're getting close to the end of the day too, so not badly done. We basically have got the cargo containers here, and we've got the ZiKZ here. Choices here. I can either just hook up this trailer and take it, or I can nip past it, get my semi-trailer, shuffle these guys off here onto the semi-trailer and use that, which I think is what I'm going to do. Simply because it's just that much more stable. past my 8 o'clock. There we go, 9:30. So we ran on a little bit later than expected in that one, but you know, these are the things you have fun with. But we managed to bring the ZiKZ in. We've got it with its seismic vibration unit on it, and we've now also got the Tayga ready to drop off this nice double cargo container load. So that's it for today. Hopefully you enjoyed watching. Thanks for watching. And yeah, hopefully you'll join me again tomorrow when we'll push on with the contracts in NAI. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Bye-bye.